You can't make me want what I don't want. You can't dangle something in front of my face that's, I don't want that. And many of you are taking anything because you don't know what you want. And so if I can do one thing for you when you leave this room, I don't want nothing from you but for you to leave this room and know what you want. What do you want in your marriage? What do you want with your son and your daughter? What do you want in your health? What do you want financially? Like, how much money do you want to make a year? What do you want to drive? How do you want to live? Stop just waking up like an accident. What do you want? And then once you find out what you want, spend the rest of your natural life waking up and going after it. The reason why I speak with so much passion, E.T., why do you speak with so much authority? Because I'm talking about my life, not something that I read. I ate out of trash cans. I had no business eating out of trash cans. I lived in abandoned buildings. I had no business living in abandoned buildings. But E.T., your daddy wasn't in your life. Your mom was a teenage mother. You grew up, come on, E, look at your shirt. That's not an excuse. There is no excuse for not living up to your fullest potential. No excuse. I told you, I didn't get a new daddy. I didn't get a new mama. What changed? I changed. And I stopped being a victim. I stopped saying, I've got to wait for good things to happen to me. And I said, I'm going to grind. I'm going to fight. I'm going to work. I'm going to press toward. I'm going to learn. I'm going to do everything in my power every single day. I'm going to do everything in my power to become a victor and not a victim. Now, let me say this before I move forward, and I can't explain it, but you better feel me. Winners win and losers lose. I can't explain it any better than that. I don't know how it happens, but winners win. And if you create a culture of losing, if you keep being a victim, if you keep letting losing happen to you, if you keep letting people do you and treat you any kind of way, it's going to become a culture. Let me tell y'all, I'm not from New Zealand, guys. Come on, listen to me very closely. I'm not from New Zealand, but I know about, let me say it this way so I can help you. I know about what team. I've never seen All Blacks play a day in my life. I've never been to the stadium. Where's the stadium? Help me out. Where's the stadium? Okay, I'm going. See what you did? I've never been to the stadium. You're like, Eric, the stadium? That's Hobbit that way, Eric. That's not the stadium. The stadium is this way. I've never been there a day in my life. And if you watch some of my videos, I have All Blacks in my videos. Why? Because they're what? They're winners. And when you're a winner, you don't even stay in your own little town. When you're a winner, winning spreads. So everybody, I got videos where I'm like, y'all, I don't really know how to show my passion. Somebody said, get the All Blacks. I'm like, yep, that's what I need, All Blacks. Yep, I need the All Blacks. I need to, why? Because they say what I'm saying. They just saying it in rugby. I don't know. I'm like, woo, that's a violent sport. Their passion is all over there. Why? Because winners win. And I can't explain it to you, but you better stop making excuses and find a way to win. Because once you start winning, you go from 1,500 to 3,000 to 5,000 to 7,000. You remember, see? From 7 to 10. Nothing changed. We're still in the basement. We don't have a building. We still use the garage for all of our products. We don't have business cards. We don't have a 5-year plan. We don't have a 3-year plan. How do you do it then? We wake up and grind. Winners win. I focus more on winning than I focus on structure. I focus on winning. And when you become a winner, they start seeing you with winners. You get from being a loser, low self-esteem, doubt, and fear. And if you can find your way on this side, guys, it's sweeter on this side. You know what's so funny? We want people to make guarantees to us, but we're not willing to make guarantees to ourselves. Now, for real, I'm gonna say it again. Like, somebody gave you a guarantee, $30, 30-day guarantee. In 30 days, if you don't make what they told you was gonna make, in 30 days, you got an attitude, you want your money back. But you've never demanded your money back from yourself. You've never looked at yourself in the mirror and said, you let you down. Until you get to that point, you let you down. You're not brave enough. You want to put it on somebody else. The reason why I'm not successful is because of my boss. Have you ever looked at yourself in the mirror and said, I'm not getting up on time. I'm not going to work on time. I'm not putting in 120% when I'm at work. I let me down. And when you get to the point where you can say you let you down, I don't care. Listen to me. No disrespect. I don't care about Glenn. That's not why I do what I do. And I love Glenn. I don't come here and do what I do so Glenn can affirm me, so he can give me a pat on my back. I care more about me than I care about what Glenn thinks about me. I have standards. I have values. I don't care how much you pay me. If I speak at an elementary school for $300, I chose to do that for $300. If I chose to speak at a prison for free, I chose to do that. And I will not go in there giving those prisoners less than what somebody pays me $100,000. Why? Because I value myself enough to give 120% or don't do it. And that's the problem with some of you. You always want to blame other people. You want to hold other people to the fire, but you're not holding yourself to the fire. You just said you're giving 50%. You owe you an explanation. You need to look at yourself in the mirror and say, why are you only giving 50%? What's wrong with you? You need to put yourself on punishment. You need to tell you no more TV, no more snacks, no more desserts, no more. No, we working out now. No more alcohol. Not right now. I can't handle it right now. You need to tell you that you owe you something. Stop going back to, you keep going to the mall with the receipt. This is what y'all said it was. Glenn, you didn't do what you said you was gonna do. Well, you didn't do what you were supposed to do, so how am I gonna do what I'm supposed to do for you? You walk out of this room, you owe yourself. I didn't get here making excuses. So what, my father wasn't in my life? The truth of the matter is, he ain't never come into my life. So what, I'm gonna wait for the rest of my life for my man to come? He ain't coming. I live in America. I'm an African-American male. They don't treat us the same. It's something called racism. I ain't gonna cry about it. It's probably gonna be racism to the day I die, but I'm not gonna cry about it. I'm still gonna be a millionaire. I'm still gonna be one of the top motivational speakers in the world. No, I didn't grow up on that side of the town. No, my mama don't have no network. No, I don't know a whole lot of people. No, I'm not at a country club. No, I don't play golf, and I don't plan on playing no time soon. But I'm still gonna be successful. I'm still gonna get to where they are. Why? Because I owe it to myself. And can't nobody stop me but me. And you need to get rid of them excuses, and you need to stop pointing fingers at people. And you need to start pointing fingers at yourself. What did you not do?